Okay, party people, welcome to the new game of the day. This one is going to be Scandinavian defense. Basically, we finished our Sicilian defense series. This one is going to be Bronstein against Lusikov. It was played in 1960 in Leningrad during the USSR championship. Again, Bronstein, one of the greatest players. One of the greatest tacticians of the 60s. He almost became a world champion. He played against Botvinnik, I guess, in 61. And Botvinnik had a really hard time winning against him. So, let's look at the game here. Lutikov played the Scandinavian defense. You don't see that kind that opening that often nowadays. And here, White played the rather unusual bishop b5. Black plays bishop to d7, and now Siuri is playing the bishop to c4, but Bronstein played the bishop to e2. He wanted a more original game. Black just took. White plays standard d4. And here comes a bad idea from Black from Lutikov. He plays g6. Usual or better move would have been to go for e6 and then develop the bishop on this diagonal. The problem is with g6 is that you lose a lot of time for your development, and White can develop effortlessly. And Bronstein played bishop. Knight to c3, developing his pieces, and Black plays bishop to g7, and here we see c5. You can play c5. It's not the best move. But idea would have been to play knight to f3. Bronstein was an original player, and he liked unusual lines. And but at the end of the day, if you have to play your knight back to c8, it's not a good sign. It doesn't speak very well of your opening, so you know something has gone wrong. And here White, okay, this is a bad move. It looks good. You have 2 points in the center, but they are easily attacked, and you made another pawn move, so you are losing now time too, which is completely useless. A better move would have been just to play the bishop to f3, developing your piece. But White still has a slight advantage here. Black rightfully tries to attack the center. He plays c6. White plays his queen to b3, and we see b6 again, trying to break up this pawn center here, which is easy. This was the right strategy from Black, playing c6 and b6. This is still okay for Black. Now White plays bishop f3, which he should have done 2-3 moves ago. And here at the end of the day, here basically Black is doing okay. He has castled. White has not castled. He has a long bishop diagonal. And White center is not stable. You can exchange it anytime you want. White develops the other bishop. He plays bishop e3, and White captures here. And this is the right idea. He wants to destroy White's pawn center, and he wants to develop his knight to c6. So he needs c6 for his knight. And White captures on d5 with his bishop, and Black plays knight to c6. And White plays rook to d1, eyeing on the queen, and this position is still is equal. Black plays queen to c6, c7, and White attacks the queen. A much better move would have been just to play, let's say, knight to e2 or f3. Because basically your development is not finished, and this leads nowhere. You know, Black just plays queen to b7, and We see knight to d4 from by white, and okay, I mean, up to this point black played very good, and now he makes horrible moves. I mean, he plays rook b8. I mean, look at this move. What is the idea? I mean, if you have this diagonal here, you have to play e6. You have to protect f7. You cannot do let white do what it wants. Okay, we see rook b8, and finally white develops his last piece. He plays knight to f3, and now we see e5. This is a really, really bad move. Again, e6 would have been here, would have saved black here. Okay, he plays e6, and imagine now what white plays. It's not that hard to see. Yeah, he captures on f7, and the best move here, according to the engine, and it really is the best move, would have been to play the king to h8. But okay, you don't want to. It would have been the right move, but yeah. Thankfully, Lutikov took with the rook, and the funny thing is, this is already losing. You can play basically this. I mean, here white took, yeah, and he played this idea, but he could have even played more primitive, and he could have played just knight to g5. I mean, if this rook is pinned, you want to attack it. This is a standard maneuver, playing the knight to g5. I mean, if a rook is if a piece is pinned, then attack it. And here, black is completely lost. If he tries the knight to d8 to protect the rook, then so you can simply play. Capturing on f7, and this is winning. You just play c6, you just fork those pieces, and this is winning. You have already an advantage of 2 points or something. So this would have been the very, very primitive variation. Another idea would have been to capture here. Yeah, you go just for material, you pick up everything, you capture everything, but here white has this move, and yeah, this is I mean, if you want to be completely mad and capture here, then white has a mate in 2. Show you even this one, and if the black king goes to h8, then you play queen to g8, and this is mate. And if he goes to f8, then you play just simply queen f7. So this is completely hopeless, so you cannot take. Another idea would have been to play the bishop to e6, then you play check on h6, and you just capture, and this is completely winning. I mean, the king has basically no good squares, and you have a solid advantage. And I mean, as I said, even in the most primitive variations, you win. But Bronchan wanted to play a little bit more active, or I don't know, a little bit more complicated. And he took with his knight on c6. Black took back with his bishop. And now he played this idea. He played rook to d8. White blocked it, playing bishop to f8. You have now another nice setup. You can always play your bishop to h6 and pin this piece. Knight to g5 is still in the game, in the position. Okay, white took here. He played knight to e5, and this is it's the strongest move, but white had many choices. Let's put it this way. Black captures here. He plays b to c5, hoping to exchange pieces and trying to survive. But here, white goes for bishop h6, and the idea is that after this exchange, you get a winning endgame. Now, white takes a rook. And yeah, I mean, if you look at this position, this piece is pinned, this piece is attacked, and so you will lose one piece. He played bishop to g2, rook to g1, bishop to b7, and now he just goes for the better endgame. You have won the exchange, and after rook to g5, black here resigns. He just transfers his rook over to the A line and picks up all his pawns, and this is a complete hopeless for black. So this was a very interesting game, because yeah, Bronstein lost his opening advantage, but he got it back, and yeah, basically black played really two bad moves and yeah, throw the whole game away. But this is chess. I mean, you can basically play a good game, and then after 15 moves or something, two weak moves, and it's over. This is completely over. There's no way to save this. And Bronstein really here played the best variations. Yeah, he wanted basically with knight to c6, he wanted to get his rook into the play. He wanted to get this open d file, so that after this move, yeah, this is the only move, so that you have this bishop to h6 idea. And he just took, I mean, if you can take this this pawn and pin here, then you know it's over. So black could have resigned here easily. But he was hoping for a queen exchange. I mean, I don't know if bishop h6 here is the best move. What is it that the engine wants? Yeah, I mean, the engine wants to play very primitive. Take the rook, then you exchange, and you go for this one. Only move. And yeah, I mean, this knight is protected. Completely not really developed. This is okay. Let's look at the variations. Let's play something like this, and yeah, we have. Let's look at the pieces. This is interesting. Yeah, I mean, white has the exchange. And he's still at the attack, so yeah, I mean, it's yeah, I mean, this Scandinavian is kind of tricky, but as you saw, you can, you know, come forward and you can do something, but yeah, you have to be very careful in the middle game. So it's very nice game, I would say. I would really urge you to look at the variations after black captures on f7. Those are basic variations, basic ideas. You have the smoothed mate, you have yeah, basic ideas attacking the pinned pieces, and the variations are not that hard. So I would really urge you to look at the variations after bishop f7. Okay, thank you very much. Bye bye.